Hey, welcome back in to our video series about controlling taxes and paying less in taxes in retirement with Roth Strategies. I am Peter Richon, founder of Richon Planning, author of Understanding Your Investment Options. So let's continue our discussion on Roth accounts, about controlling your taxes in retirement, and how to pay less in tax in retirement. On the last video, we talked about strategies for income eliminated individuals. Now, not everybody's income eliminated. So where we have the opportunity to make contributions, we really want to maximize those opportunities and take full advantage. Remember, contributions are subject to limits and limitations. And so not everybody can take advantage, or we can't put as much money as we want to into these accounts. Some folks are eliminated because they earn too much money, or they've already maximized other opportunities. So let's talk about how we can take full advantage and get as much money into, brand new money into, these accounts that will grow tax-free for our financial future and controlling that tax bill in retirement. If we're married, we can double up our contributions. So let's say that I'm in a household where only one spouse is working. Maybe the other's a homemaker or just not in the professional field, not employed. The spouse that's working can actually double up and make their own contributions and make a contribution for their spouse. So let's say that they're under the age of 50. That could be not six, but $12,000 per year that we could get into a Roth IRA. You can use your return. It's another great strategy. If you're getting a tax return, why not turn around, take the money that the government's giving you back where you overpaid in tax, and put it in an account where it will never be taxed again into the future. It'll grow tax-free, the income will be tax-free, and the inheritance, if you pass any on to your beneficiaries, will pass tax-free as well. Bonus here, between January 1st and tax filing date of April 15th, usually, you can actually double up your contributions for two different tax years. You can do one for this tax year, and you can do one for the last tax year. So if you're using your return, it's a great opportunity. You could get a lot of money in real quick. You can contribute over the match. So some people are taking advantage. If you are contributing over the match at work, let's say they match the first 5% of your salary, but you're contributing 10% of your salary to your 401k. You may want to pause. You may want to speak with your financial and tax professional about that decision and see if it would be advantageous to redirect the amount that is over the match to your Roth IRA instead. Now, if your company's offering a match on your 401k contributions, you always want to take full advantage. There's really nowhere else in the financial world that you can get that kind of guaranteed immediate return that is offered by a match on your invested dollars. But if you're maxing out your match, or if you're contributing to a 401k and those dollars are not being matched, we may want to carefully consider pivoting, redirecting, and making those contributions to a Roth IRA instead. Now, some employer-sponsored plans, 401ks, 403bs, they offer a Roth component. So you can actually make a Roth contribution to your 401k. This is a great opportunity because it offers significantly higher contribution limits than an IRA. If you're 50 years old or older, an IRA, your contribution limit this year in 2020, and I believe it's already been announced for 2021 that it's staying the same, will only be $7,000. That's the max that you can contribute. Whereas in an employer-sponsored plan, if you're over the age of 50, you can contribute your $19,500 plus a catch-up provision of another $6,500. That's $26,000. That you could get into your employer-sponsored Roth 401k. If your employer does not offer one, or you're not sure, it's definitely worth asking. If they say, no, we don't offer, it's definitely worth asking if they could potentially change the plan and offer that Roth 401k. So again, some quick math here. What's the maximum that you could get into Roth accounts growing tax-free for your financial future in a single given year? Well, if you're over the age of 50 and you're making a contribution for yourself and for your spouse, and let's say that you did this between January 1st and tax filing date of April 15th, so that's $14,000 for two different years, that's $28,000, and then both of you are making contributions to your employer-sponsored 401k Roths, that's up to $80,000 that you could get into your retirement accounts for tax-free growth, tax-free income in retirement, and tax-free inheritance in a single given year. That's a great opportunity if maybe you got a windfall or maybe you're really looking to supercharge and catch up on your retirement savings. If you're working to 70 and a half or 72, the typical age where the contributions stop being allowed to IRAs, you can contribute to a Roth IRA. There was never any age limitation or restriction on Roth IRA contributions. Now, you do have to have earned income, but there is no age limitation. In fact, with the Secure Act, they waive the age limitation on IRA contributions as well. You can also double up another way. You can take advantage of both your workplace plan, your 401k, and your individual retirement account, your IRA. There's nothing that says that they are mutually exclusive and you can only do one or the other. And in fact, you can have a great advantage from potentially doing both. So again, lots of opportunities to maximize those contributions. To recap, we want to take full advantage because we know what tax rates are today. We can manage taxes as we're earning that paycheck. And then the growth on those accounts, the income from those accounts are all tax-free for us into our future with the Roth IRA or the Roth 401k. In our next video, we're going to discuss some specific strategies for maximizing your conversions. So be sure to stay tuned. If you've already got a large amount in tax-deferred accounts, you especially want to check out this next video and learn more about paying less in taxes.